In part one of our lesson on finding trig values using a calculator, we're going to go over how to use a calculator to evaluate function values and find angles. In this first example, we have to evaluate each trig function. So this first one asks us to find the sine of 35 degrees, 18 minutes. Next, I'll demonstrate how to do this calculation on a Texas Instruments TI-30X2S calculator. So, first order of business, get your calculator turned on with the lower left button. Next, you want to make sure that you're in degree mode. So, you go to the DRG button, and you'll see you have several options there, degrees, radians, gradients. You want to make sure that the cursor is underneath the degrees, and then go ahead and hit enter. Now we're ready to begin the calculation. So we're going to enter our trig function, which is sine, and we're going to input 35. Now, to tell the calculator that it's degrees, you have to hit the degrees, minutes, and seconds button. It defaults under degrees, so we'll only need to hit enter. Now you'll input 18, and we have to tell the calculator that it's minutes, so go back to the degrees, minutes, seconds button, and use your right cursor to move over one to get under the minutes, and then go ahead and hit enter. Next, you'll just close the parentheses and then hit enter to tell the calculator to do the calculation. And your display now shows you that you have the sine of 35 degrees, 18 minutes is equal to 0.577857624. In the next example, we have to take secant of 104 degrees, and we see that our calculator does not have a secant button, so we'll be using a reciprocal identity. So we're going to input 1 divided by, we know the trig function will be cosine. We'll input the 104, and because we don't have any subdivision of the degree into minutes or seconds, we don't have to enter the degree symbol. We can just input the parentheses and then hit enter. And you can see your calculator displays 1 divided by cosine of 104 is equal to negative 4.1335654. In the next example, we have to find an angle in the interval 0 to 90 degrees that satisfies each equation. So in part A, we're given that cosine of theta is equal to 0.7351. We're trying to solve for theta, so we know that to undo a function, we have to use the inverse function. So we're going to take the cosine inverse of the left-hand side as well as the right-hand side. So the left-hand side becomes cosine inverse of cosine theta equals the right-hand side, which is cosine inverse of 0.7351. Now the left-hand side, we know that a function and its inverse undo each other, and we'll be left with theta. And now on the right-hand side, We grab our calculator and do this calculation. We always want to verify that we're in degree mode, as we need to be, and we're ready to do our calculation. So we have to hit the second button. Then we go over to the cosine to get the cosine inverse, which is above it. Then we're going to enter 0.7351. Then we're going to close our parentheses. And then we'll hit enter. And now if we round to the tenths place, we can see our result is going to be theta is equal to 42.7 degrees. In this next example, we have that the tangent of theta is equal to 1.297. Let's check your understanding. So pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. So to solve this one, we know we're going to have to do the inverse trig function. So we're going to be taking the tangent inverse of the left-hand side, and we'll have to take the tangent inverse of the right-hand side. So we get tangent inverse of tangent theta is going to equal tangent inverse of 1.297. Tangent inverse of tangent of theta reduces to theta, and the right-hand side will grab our calculators and do this calculation. To get to the inverse function, we'll use the second key, then go over to the tangent button, hit tangent to get at that tangent inverse, then we'll enter 1.297, close the parentheses, and then hit the enter. Rounding to the tenths place, we see we're going to get 52.4 degrees. In this next example, we have to find an angle in the interval 0 to 90 that satisfies each equation. And in part A, we have to find an angle such that the cosecant of theta is equal to 5.97. Now we know that our calculators don't have cosecant, but they do have sine. So the first thing we can do is use a reciprocal identity and say that sine of theta has to equal 1 over 5.97. Now we know that we can do the inverse trig function, and we have to do the same thing to both sides. So we'll be taking the sine inverse of the left-hand side as well as taking the sine inverse of the right-hand side. So the left-hand side is sine inverse of sine of theta. The right-hand side is sine inverse of 1 over 5.97. Now the left-hand side simplifies to become theta. And on the right-hand side, we'll need to use our calculators to do the calculation. To get to an inverse trig function, we know we're going to need to use the second key. So we hit second, and then we go to the sine key, hit it to get the sine inverse. Then we're going to do 1 divided by 5.97. We'll need to close our parentheses, and then hit enter. And we see that theta is going to simplify to the tenths place to be 9.6 degrees. Next up, we have cotangent theta is equal to 4.53. It's CYU time, so pause the video, work the example on your own, then restart the video to check your answer. Okay, let's see how you did. Once again, we know our calculators don't have cotangent theta, so we're going to use the reciprocal identity and say that tangent of theta is equal to 1 over 4.53. Now we know we're going to have to take the inverse tangent of both sides. So the left-hand side becomes tangent inverse of the tangent of theta. And the right-hand side becomes the tangent inverse of 1 over 4.53. Now the tangent inverse of the tangent of theta simplifies to be theta. And on the right-hand side, we'll need to use our calculators. Once again, to get at the inverse trig function, we'll hit the second key, go over to the tangent button, hit it to get tangent inverse, then we'll enter 1 divided by 4.53, then we'll close our parentheses, and then we'll hit the enter button. So rounding to the tenths place, we see that theta is going to be 12.4 degrees. Now, in this next example, we have to determine if each statement is true or false. So looking at part A here, we have cosine 15 degrees plus cosine 10 degrees is equal to cosine of 25 degrees. And we have to decide if that is a true statement or a false statement. So we're going to use our calculators to evaluate each side separately, and then we'll compare the two results that we get. So let's go ahead and evaluate this left-hand side using our calculators. So we'll click on cosine, enter the 15, close the parentheses, hit the plus sign, hit cosine, enter the 10 degrees, close the parentheses, and hit enter. So we see we have 1.9507 dot dot dot. Then we're going to clear that out and do the right hand side. We've got cosine of 25, close the parentheses, come over and hit enter. And we see we get 0.9063 dot dot dot. So we can see these two definitely do not equal each other. So this statement is false. So something really important to notice here is that you can't just add up the arguments. So cosine of 15 plus cosine of 10 is never going to equal cosine of 25, and that's true for all the trig functions. In part B, we have the sine of 70 is equal to 2 times the sine of 35 times the cosine of 35. So once again, we'll evaluate each side separately and see if the numbers we get are the same. To evaluate the left-hand side, we'll hit sine 70, close the parenthesis, hit enter. So the left-hand side is 0.93969 dot dot dot. Clear out the calculator, Then we get 2 sine 35, close the parenthesis, times cosine 35, close that parenthesis, and then hit enter. It's also 0.93969. So these two turned out to be equal to each other. So therefore, this is a true statement. In part C, we have tangent of 43 degrees equals 1/2 of the tangent of 86 degrees. And again, we're trying to decide if that's true or false. So we evaluate the left-hand side, and let's see what we get. We see we're going to take the tangent of 43 degrees, close the parenthesis, hit enter, and we get 0.9325 dot dot dot. Clear the calculator. Then on the right-hand side, put in a parenthesis, 1/2. So you have to hit the fraction button there. Put in the 2, close the parenthesis, times the tangent of 86 degrees, close the parenthesis, and then hit enter. 7.15. Well, those are definitely not equal to each other, so this statement is false.